Shalom. Let's solve this worksheet. Let's start with the word nose in Hebrew, which is af. So let's write af. Under the aleph, you have this little line. It's a patach. It's a sound, so af. In cursive, you don't have to write vowels. You can just write af. The next word we're going to do is going to be mouth. Mouth in Hebrew is peh. Like that. Inside the peh, the letter peh, you have a dagesh. It signifies it's a p instead of f when it doesn't have a dagesh. Usually, the peh will always have a dagesh at the beginning of the word because it's the beget kefet letter. We can do another lesson about that later. In cursive, you will write pe, like this. You don't have to put a dagesh. You could if you wanted to, but you don't have to. Okay, what's our next word? Our next word is this, chin. How do we say chin in Hebrew? Chin in Hebrew is santer. San, ter. Samech nun tetresh. Under the samech, you have a patach again, this little line which signifies a sound, sa. Under the nun, you have two dots, one under the other, it's a shva. It's a n sound. And under the tet, you have two little dots over here that are called a tsere. It makes a te sound. So it's santer. Cursive. Santer. This one got a little connected over here. So let's redo these two letters. Tet and resh santer. You don't have to put vowels again. Okay, next is your eye. How are we going to say eye in Hebrew? Eye in Hebrew is ein. Ein. The vowels, patach under the ein, and achirik, isan under the yod. When you want to write this in cursive, it's very simple. Ein, yud, nun. A lot of times we use it in plural and we say eyes. So in order to say eyes, we can say, we can write it over here. Eyes in plural is a naim. A naim. And here you have the vowels. Under the yud is the chirik. See how hard it is to write like that? It's much easier to write in cursive. But sometimes the spelling in cursive changes because you don't have vowels. Okay? So when we are going to write eyes, we're going to write it like this. We're going to write it with two yuds. Okay? Next, we are going to do our hair. This person's hair. How do we say hair in Hebrew? Hair in Hebrew is se'ar. Let's write it down. This dot right here signifies it's a sin and not a shin. If the dot is on this side, it's a sh sound, but it's on the left side here, so it's a s sound. So we know that this is a s sound. And under this sin, you have a tsere, the two dots. It's a se sound now. And under the ein, you have a kamatz, which makes it a sound. So together, it's se'ar. In cursive, it changes a little bit because we don't have vowels again. And you write it like this. Se'ar. Next is your ear. How do we say ear in Hebrew? Ear in Hebrew is ozen. Let's write it down. Ozen. Now we have a tzere right here. This little dot is a cholam chaser, which means that if you have this aleph and then a vav, it has a dot, the o sound. But when you don't have the vav and you only have the dot, it's still o sound. Okay, So this is why it's not Ozen or anything like that. It's Ozen. And when you want to write this in cursive, you are actually going to write it like this. Because you don't have vowels, so you add that vowel over there. But of course, we use the plural a lot. So how do we say plural ear? How do we say ears in Hebrew? The answer is oznaim. So let's write it down. Oznaim. And here we have patach and achirik. Oznaim. And of course that if you are writing in cursive, you change it up a little bit, the spelling, and it goes oznaim. Perfect. We just finished the worksheet. So let's review what we've learned today. Okay, we started with our af. We went to our pe. We continued with the santer. We learned how to say I, ein, eyes, einaim. We then learned to say hair, se'ar. Ozen, for ear, and ears is oznaim. Thank you for watching. Toda rabah.